Hey, good afternoon, YouTube. So this is my horizontal bandsaw, and one of the things I cut every once in a while are these polyurethane tubes. So this is a half-inch wall, 1¾ inch inside, and 2¾ inch outside diameter. It's fairly stiff, but it's flexible. One of the problems I have when I cut it is the drag of the saw blade through the tube kind of pulls the tube over and it cuts really crooked. So I've done three things to make it cut really square. One is I've added this little extension to the vise on the saw. So it's just a piece of flat bar that I drilled a couple of holes in the back of the vise. So that basically goes up to about where the saw blade ends. And then I can slide my tube through. And so the little thing I added here on the outside is a piece of aluminum I machined to take a couple of screws down here that I tapped holes into the base. And then I milled this face to line up with this face of the vise. So this provides the port on the back side of the tube to keep it from bending this way when you cut. And then the last thing I do is I have a little polyurethane bushing, and so I just fit that inside, and then I can cut, and this bushing keeps the outside from collapsing, this fence keeps it from bending, and then being that it's supported on both sides behind, I get a really nice square cut. Let me show you what that looks like here. I'll get that set up. Yeah, so there I've got my piece in there, and this is basically what I'm making, is a little donut out of the polyurethane, and it's sized to fit over this bushing, and I make a small bushing into a large bushing, because the thing that happens is I end up with a lot of these small bushings left over from other projects, and I need bushings that are this big, so I can turn little bushings into big bushings. And so I'll show you how it cuts here. I think I'm all squared away. There we go. Got the piece cut, and I just use that piece inside to fill it up. I keep it slightly exposed on this end when I'm cutting, because you know I want it to be the exact thickness here. So now all I do is I clean this up on a belt sander, smooth it flat and kind of round over the corners a little bit, and there's one of my pieces. So with polyurethane, it's quite expensive to make the molding and the, you know, the tooling to produce bushings, and then you got to buy the material and get it professionally cast. By the time you do enough to make it worthwhile, I end up with probably 10 years worth of what I could sell. So this way I can make up just a few as I need them. And I think I got one more to make today, and then I can ship this order out. This is a handy little gadget if you're cutting anything polyurethane or rubber or anything that's kind of flexible. This provides a little support beyond the blade. You can see it's just a 1-inch piece of aluminum, and I left the tab on the bottom. 1 8-millimeter screw that goes in with a head on it, and then I have a little set screw inside the upper hole there just to hold it vertical like that. And then just started whittling away here at this face, and then kept installing it, and then use a straight edge across the vise to the face of that, because you pretty much get one chance to make this the right offset. If you cut too much in here, you got to throw it away and start all over again. So you have to kind of whittle this down and keep measuring, because you want to get a nice flat surface across there. So yeah, it's a little tedious to make, but once you make it, you just drop it on and it's ready to go. So yeah, I just thought I'd pass on my couple little saw adapters there. If you ever need to cut anything soft in a horizontal bandsaw, that's the way to do it. If you have any questions about that, put that in the comments section below. And as always, thanks for watching.